Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video I want to share with you 5 most popular JavaScript interview questions that I got over the last 10 years. So let's jump right into it. The most popular question that I got is what are closures in JavaScript? I got this question in every single interview during the last 10 years, because for some reason people think that this is a really difficult topic and only people with advanced knowledge know this topic. But actually this is core base knowledge of JavaScript, and you need for sure to learn this. And also just don't go to JavaScript interview if you don't know the answer to this question, because you will get it there for sure. Let's check on the example. Let's create here a function. So let's say we want to create a function add2, and this is a function where inside we have a property, for example, argument passed. Now inside this function we have a local variable inner, and here the value is 2. Now we want to return here passed plus inner. And we simply call this function, for example, here is console.log add2, and we're passing here 3. So here passed is 3, and we just plus these two variables, and here, as you can see in browser, we are getting 5, which means everything is working. Now let's say that we want this function to work, but we want to move this passed property outside. How can we do this? Of course we can create this property outside. For example, here before we're saying that this is the passed variable and it is 3. And actually now inside this function we can use this passed variable, because inside functions we always have access to the properties which we wrote outside. In this case here we have access to our passed variable which we wrote before. Let's reload the page. As you can see we still get 5, but now this passed is outside the function. And actually this is already closure. Closure means that inside our function we are getting access to variables which are defined outside of the function. But actually this is not the most clear example of using closures. This is why I will remove here passed and everything inside, and now here I want to create new function inside our function add2. So here is just a simple function, we don't write anything inside, and then we simply return here function add. So actually we don't do anything here, we don't call this add function, we simply return it. Which means here we can call this function, and as you can see in browser we are getting back a function, because we are getting back this add function which we wrote inside. Now let's add some arguments. For example, here we can add passed like we have before, and now in the inner function we are adding inner, so additional argument. And now inside we want to return passed plus inner. And actually the idea is exactly like before. We have passed not from this add function, but from the outside. And as you can see we have access to passed, which is passed here before. Now if we will reload the page, as you can see we are getting back the inner function, which means here inside add2 we can for example say 3. And this thing will return us a function, this inner function add. And now after this we actually can call it again, because this is our inner function and we are passing here inner property, for example 2, we are checking in browser and this is 5. So actually this is exactly the example of closure. We have our inner function and it has access to the variables of outer function, in our case variable passed. To make it more clear, we can write add2 3 in additional property. For example, here is add3 and here add2, and we are passing here inside 3. What does it mean? Now we can write here console.log add3 and this will be a function, and inside we can say for example 2. So here we will add 3 because the function is add3, and we will add here 2 that we passed inside. Let's check this out. This is exactly the same, so this code equals this code. And now here is an important part to understand closures really good. We can use here console.dir, and we can write inside our function add3. And actually all our functions are objects. This is why we can with console.dir check what is inside. So let's save this and reload the page. As you can see, this is our add function, which we console logged here. So add 3 returns add function. This is why here we can open it and we have a lot of stuff which is stored inside our function. We're interested in this part which is called scopes. We can open it, and as you can see here is closure, and we're interested exactly in this. So closure here is exactly all variables which are available for us from outside, and as you can see here we have access to pass it 3. What does it mean? Normally browser removes all variables inside the functions after we called this function. But not in this case, because actually we have a reference to this passed variable, which means actually this passed variable won't be deleted until we call our add3 function, which means we have this reference to passed which was in parent function. This is exactly the closure. So here is a short answer on interview, what is closure? First of all, closure is an inner function with access to all variables of parent function or global namespace. Secondly, this inner function has access to all variables even after parent function was already executed. And browser stores all variables inside parent function until inner function exists. The second question, which is super popular, is hoisting. So what is hoisting? Is bubbling of definition of variables and functions. And actually here you normally are getting some example like this. For example, you have here console log foo, and after this you just write foo equals 1. So normally interviewer will ask you what will be console logged here. And you need to understand how it is working at all. And actually in JavaScript only 2 things are bubbling to the top of the file, which means when we are writing var a equals 1, it means that the definition of a will come to the top of the file, doesn't matter in what line we are writing this var a. And then at the line when we wrote var a equals 1, actually it will be assigned. And this is why all these questions are popping up, because in our case here we have console log foo, and actually this foo is not defined in this code at all, which means in this case we will get an error, foo is not defined. And it doesn't matter that here we wrote foo equals 1, this variable is not defined at the moment when this console log is executed. Let's check. I'm reloading the page and we are getting foo is not defined. Now here is one more question regarding hoisting. For example, here we have console log foo, and after this var foo equals 2. And the question is, what will be console logged here in this case? And actually you need to say, okay, this var foo bubbles to the top, which means at the beginning it will be undefined. So actually this is the same like here we are writing var foo. And after this, at this line, we have assignment, which means at the moment when we have here console log, foo is not assigned yet, which means here foo will be undefined, and after this here we will assign foo. Let's reload the page. As you can see, here is undefined. And now the last question, for example, here we have foo equals 3. Now here is our console log foo, and after this we have var foo. So what will happen here? Exactly like previously, var foo will bubble to the top, so it will be the first one, then we assign 3 to our foo variable, and then we console log this variable. This is why inside we will have 3. Let's check this out. As you can see, here it is 3. So actually you need to remember that var and function declarations are bubbling to the top. This is why you have all this tricky question. But actually you can also mention here that you are using not vars, but lets and cons and arrow functions. And actually let, const and arrow functions are not bubbling at all. So you have them exactly in the line when you assign them. For example, with this code, like let equals 3, and maybe you have here some arrow function foo, you are defining these variables in the place where you defined them. So you don't have any bubbling and any problems. And actually in modern projects you are not using vars and functions at all, but you are writing ECMAScript 6 like consts, lets and arrow functions. This is why it is also worth to mention it. The next super popular question is, what is this and context inside JavaScript? And actually if you want to learn it deeper, I made a full video regarding it, and I will link it here on the top, so if you want you can check it. And actually we are getting such question. So for example, we have the object and we have a message inside this object. And here is the method getMessage. Inside we have a variable message and here return this message. Now inside our console log, we are writing object.getMessage. So the question is, what will be console logged here? So this is the question on the basic understanding on this. And actually the thing that may bother you here is that you have here return this message and local property message. And you must know that this references its parent. And inside object, it references the object itself, which means in this case here, this will be our object. This is why getMessage will return here this message, hello world, and it doesn't have anything to do with our local variable message here. Let's check this out. I am reloading the page and we are getting hello world. And here is a little bit more advanced example on using this and context. As you can see here, we have a class, here is our constructor, and we are assigning a name as an argument to our this. So inside pet, we have this name. Now we have here, first of all, not a method, but an arrow function and just a plain function. Now here we create our instance of pet, this is our cat, and here we console log cat get name and cat surname. So actually the question is, what will be returned here? So to answer this question, you need to understand how this is working inside arrow function and plain function. And actually, it doesn't matter that we are writing here function and arrow function inside our class, because for us it's important that in this case, this name is written inside arrow function. And here this name is written inside plain function. So you need to know that inside function word, when you are writing this, you have a reference not to the parent, but to the global context. For example, in our case, it will be window or undefined. And actually here in our arrow function, we have a reference to the parent. This is why in this case, we will have the reference to our instance, so to our pet, and then we are getting this name that we provided. But in this case, we will get undefined because name won't exist in the global namespace. Let's check this out. I am reloading the page. As you can see, this is Fluffy and here is undefined because the first case was for the arrow function and the second case was just for the plain function. The next important question is, what are references in JavaScript? And this example will help to understand if you know what we are talking about or not. And you need to know that in JavaScript, only objects and arrays are being passed by reference. All other stuff is passed by value. So let's check this example. So here we have basic config, this is just an object. And we have a function extend config, and we are passing inside some config. Now here we are assigning a new property port inside our config, and we are returning config. And as you can see here, we are calling this extend config, and we are passing inside basic config, so this object. And then here we are getting our extended config additionally with port. So actually the question for you is, what is wrong with this code? So here you need to say that the main problem is that we are passing here the object. And objects in JavaScript are being passed by reference, which means this config, when we modify it here, will modify our basic config, because this config is the reference to our basic config, because we passed it here inside our function. And normally, of course, we don't want such behavior. We want our function to be isolated. And if we pass here a config and modify it and return, then here we're returning the new config. We don't modify our old config that we passed simply to generate new config. So actually, in this case, we want to avoid mutating our old data. This is why we need somehow to create a new object. And we have two solutions for this. So this is why I will comment out this code, and here we can write, first of all, return object assign, and actually we are calling object assign on some object, and then we can add new properties from other objects to this object. And this is why if we are writing here just config, comma, and here some config, for example, port 3000, it won't be correct, because in this case, we are assigning properties from this object inside our config, and we will have exactly the same problem. But what we can do here, we can write at the first argument, first of all, the empty object, which means here we have a new object, we're overriding its properties with the config, and then we're adding inside our port. In this case, we won't mutate our basic config. Let's check this out. I want to write here console log extended config. As you can see here, we got host and port. But let's check what we have in basic config. So as you can see here, our basic config is untouched. This is exactly what we want. Now, if we will comment out this return and try how we did it previously, I will reload the page. You can see that they are the same because they are referenced on the same object. This is why this is bad code and we need to use here object assign. It is also possible to make exactly the same logic by using spread. This is why here I want to return new object and inside I am using spread of the config just to put all properties of the config inside this new object. And now additionally I want here port 3000 and it will do exactly the same. Let's reload the page. As you can see here the initial config is not touched and here we are getting our new config. And the last question that I want to show you is scope of visibility. So you can get such question. For example, we have here switch with type and we have here two cases, add and remove. And as you can see here, we created const item inside our first case and we created const item inside our second case. And actually, if I will reload the page, you can see the error. Identifier item has already been declared. And actually, the question is how we can avoid such problem. And you need to say here that actually we have these brackets on our switch, which means this is our scope, and when we define an item here, it is inside the whole switch, because our scope is here inside switch. The fix here will be to create a new scope, and actually we can create it for every single case, and then we don't have such problem. This is why we need here after case, open bracket, and here close bracket, and we can do the same for our remove. In this case, we have additional scope for every case, and we won't have such problem, and we can create the same names in every case. Let's reload the page. As you can see here, we are not getting the error about redeclaration, but the type is not defined. This is completely fine, because here we wrote switch on our type that does not exist. So here I can just for testing create type add, and let's check this out. I'm reloading the page, and we don't have any errors. So actually, it's important to understand the scopes of visibility and how they are working in JavaScript. So these were 5 questions that I heard on interviews really often. And as always, happy coding!